They just eat normal made home foods. But the right foods, the right fruits, the right vegetables, the right amount of things which are going to make them feel healthy and energetic. Even if it's an obese patient, even if it's an overweight patient, he can eat the normal foods which are really going to make him slim and yet make him feel energetic. So that's the way the diet has to be planned. But a very large-scale study from researchers shows that women who followed a combination of healthy lifestyle factors like not smoking, maintaining a healthy weight, regular physical activity, and a healthy diet, all these women who did this had a dramatically lower risk of dying from all the causes during the 2.5 decades of the study. So actually you can defer death, you can actually live a very good life. This was an actual scientific, very long-term study which was in women. So this is published in the British Medical Journal. You can see how important good living actually impacts our life. So if you have got 6 great ways to start your day, I would say if you are starting your day in the morning, you should put on some light music. It's very important because music really stimulates your mind and really refreshes you. It's very good for your mind. So today there are a lot of studies which have shown that music is really very good for our body. It has a very positive effect on our body. And the most important thing is, if you stretch out in the shower, it really gives a very good effect on our muscles. So that is very important, to have a very good shower bath. Third is, many of us have a tendency to miss out on breakfast because people say we are going early to work, we are going early to college, so they miss out on breakfast. Having a balanced breakfast is very important. I would also say, if you all like, you should form the habit of having green tea, because green tea is very loaded with antioxidants. So green tea, having that habit is very good. Another very important thing is writing your diary. You should have that habit of writing down the things, because when you're doing this, you start developing a habit of remembering things, writing down and making a note of all the important activities that you wish to do for the day, and also planning out your activities very well. That's another very important thing you need to do. Morning walk and yoga. Yoga is really very good for your body, and you will see later on how important it is for your body. Now, somebody will ask that why is breakfast in the morning very important? Why can't we have something later in the afternoon straight away? There's a reason, there's a scientific reason why you must have breakfast in the morning. Because they say that it kickstarts your metabolism. The entire night you are hungry, and in the morning when you have a breakfast, you know, you have a very high amount of hypoglycemia, because in the early part of the morning you are totally without food. So that is why you need to kickstart your metabolism in the morning, and that is why it helps you to concentrate and perform better at work, and it aids in maintaining a very good healthy weight. If you do not have breakfast in the morning, on the contrary, you tend to overeat during lunch and you tend to put on weight. So for obese people also, we tell them that you please have a very good breakfast in the morning. So having a good breakfast in the morning is very good. Now, when it comes to healthy eating, I always tell even my obese patients that please do not stick to some very strict philosophies of not having food at all for days together, or just starving yourself, being very, you know, conscious about your body. Oh, I'm so fat, I'm 120 kg, so I will stop eating totally. For days together, I will not eat. Please do not have those kind of philosophies in mind. There's nothing like that. And the mountains will not fall if you don't reduce your weight for a few months. You need to go gradually, and you need to go slowly on this. Okay? So there are no strict philosophies, no unrealistic thin, becoming thin. These kind of concepts don't exist. Okay? You need to go slow on it, and you need to have realistic pulling down on your weight. Actually today, the pendulum swings, actually, if you see, in the eating of the food. You know, in the earlier times, we used to have very natural foods, very, very, very many years back. Then came an era where we started eating processed foods. And today, if you see, again the world has shifted back to the natural foods. They are growing natural foods, Nature's Basket, you must have heard. So all these people, you know, they are now shifting back to, you know, organically grown foods and nature's foods. So the real thing, if you ask me, is to have as much as natural foods as possible rather than artificial foods, processed foods, where you have everything processed or have preservatives in it. So please avoid as much as possible. If, for example, even if you want to make a soup in the house, always have a natural soup rather than bringing packets and just putting it into the water and eating and having them. As much as natural you can have, better than artificial or preserved. Because the more preservatives you take in, the more it harms our body. So this is again the same thing what I'm saying, that you need to have a moderation. Do not try to overdo things, because when in the initial phase you try to start overdoing, you know, you get fed up of all these diets, you know. So don't try to overdo any kind of diet, and then you'll enjoy even eating all the kind of foods. I lay a lot of emphasis on fruits and vegetables in everybody's diet. You must take a lot of fruits and vegetables and a lot of greens, particularly because greens are very good for the health. Sweet vegetables also you can take if you are not very overweight. And fruits should also include some amount of fiber. Now this is the healthy eating pyramid. If you see this, this is the health eating pyramid, and this is as per the actual pyramid which we should follow. You should have a daily exercise and weight control. The actual foods which we need to take are the whole grain foods. The oils which are recommended are olive oil. Very good. You can use olive oil for your salads. Okay. But day-to-day oil in our Indian cooking, the good one I would recommend, if you can use it in your setting, is rice bran oil or canola oil. It's available easily in our markets. Okay. These are very good oils in the market. So these are the oils we can use. You should have vegetables in abundance. Fruits also, you must include at least twice or thrice a day a fruit. It's very good, 2 to 3 servings of fruits. And then if you have to eat nuts, I would recommend you should eat in the nuts, walnuts. Walnuts are very good. And almonds. These are the two nuts which you can include in your diet. These are extremely good for the health. Okay? Nuts and walnuts. In a day you can go right up to 4 to 5, 6, as much as that. Walnuts also that many. They are very good. Walnuts are extremely good for the body. Anytime you can have few in the morning, few in the afternoon. As a snacks you can have. Yeah? You can split it up, few in the morning, few in the evening. Because at one time you may not like to take so many. You can even cut them into slices and put them in your morning breakfast in oats, porridge, and eat them like that. You can even garnish them on anything and eat them with that, right? If you are taking rabri or faluda or something like that also, you can put them in that and have it. Anything you can have it with, okay? Okay? And then, if you are taking fish, poultry, eggs, no egg yolks, avoid egg yolks. Egg yolks you can take maximum once or twice a week. But please avoid egg yolks because that's very rich in cholesterol. But you can take egg whites as many as you want. That's not a problem. Okay? Amongst the meats, fish is very good. You must include a fish serving in your diet. It's very good, very healthy to eat fish because they are very good sources of omega-3 fatty acids. Okay? And among the meats, chicken is okay, but the chicken should be free from the fat. There should be no fat in the chicken. It should be removed. It should be trimmed. Red meats as far as possible to be avoided. You should include dairy also, or calcium supplement can be included in your diet. And you should use sparingly red meat, butter, white bread, white rice, potatoes, pasta, sweets, multivitamins for most, alcohol in moderation, unless contraindicated. So this is what the pyramid suggests. Okay? Start with exercise. focus on food. Do not focus on the grams, but rather focus on the food. And go more with the plants. Of course, in the non-veg, go more with the fish. Okay? And cut down on red meat and potatoes, sugary drinks, please. Sugar and salt. These things always please play it very low. Okay? Do not take more of free sugar and try to take more of complex carbohydrates. I'll be coming to that, what it is. So, which form of fruits and veggies to avoid? Now, you will not take fruit juices which are loaded with free sugar. For example, if you have, you know, juices where excess of fruit sugar is put, free sugar is put, please do not take that. You should have natural fruit juices and don't add on more sugar to that. Okay, that's not good. Or canned fruit or fried veggies, fried potatoes, you know, all the time you should avoid that. Even veggies which are heavy with dressings, loaded with fats and calories. Now, amongst the carbohydrates, you know, we have got two types. There are the healthy carbohydrates and there are the unhealthy. Now, when we say healthy, they are the complex ones, okay? Like the whole grains, the beans, the fruits and the vegetables, they are the complex carbohydrates. These are very good for the health. Whereas the free sugars, they fall under the simple sugars or the simple carbohydrates, and they tend to put on weight for us. So we tend to put on weight as and when we take a lot of free sugars. So these are the ones to be avoided. And then we have got two types of fats, the monounsaturated fats, the polyunsaturated fats. So if you take the monounsaturated fats, those are the canola oil, the olive oil, and the nuts which I told you, like almonds, hazelnuts and pecans. And polyunsaturated fats include the omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids. So the fatty fish, you know, will give you a source of omega-3 fatty acids. So you need to include the fatty fish into our diet. Also, you must have heard about flaxseed. Alsi, what we call in Hindi. Okay? So alsi is one of the sources of this omega-3 fatty acids. So those who are vegetarian people can include, instead of fish, alsi in their diet. So alsi seeds can be taken, they can be just ground in the mixer, and you can take half teaspoon of alsi twice a day. That's also a very good source of omega-3 fatty acids in the daytime. So you can take these twice a day, and they provide a very good source of omega-3 fatty acids. Water. Prior to meals, in a glass of water. That's it. So they provide a good source of omega-3 fatty acids, and they are very good for overall body functions. So these are the very good functions of omega-3 fatty acids. They are good for the body's functions, for the heart. They prevent heart disease, stroke, rheumatoid arthritis, cancer. In all these functions, they have some roles to play. And then, as I said, there are two types of omega acids. There is the eicosapentaenoic and eicosahexaenoic. And these again, as I said, flax seeds, like alsi seeds, they can provide you omega-3 fatty acids. And for the non-veg, fish can provide you. Yeah, they can be mildly roasted also, very mildly. Or, yes. But otherwise, you can even use them directly.